So controlling inflammation with autoimmunity. And the reason I bring this up is because this is an interesting topic relative to the point that it's kind of out there in the literature. It's kind of out there on these presentations. And it's that inflammation is a big player in everything. I mean, I talk to my patients from the perspective of what causes the inflammation. But just for a foundation, autoimmunity, there are a lot of triggers. There are triggers of having a baby can trigger autoimmunity, having an injury, having a surgery, having an overwhelming infection, having an overwhelming traumatic experience, stressful experience. These will all trigger autoimmunity. And in the end, what they do is they trigger these pathways that are inflammatory pathways. But life is broader than that. Okay. The bottom line I mean, life is inflammatory. If you don't sleep enough, it's inflammatory. If you sleep too much, it's inflammatory. If you overexercise for the autoimmune patient, it's inflammatory. If you have a stress, it's inflammatory. If you drink out of plastic water bottles without getting into that whole thing of the BPA, it's inflammatory. Okay. If you don't, you know, if you're always on your phone and it's starting to bother your neurology, it's inflammatory. Everything creates inflammation because inflammation is the very first reaction of our immune system to everything. Even when you get a cut, it becomes inflamed first, and then all of the cells come start to heal it, and so on and so forth. So I've been a massage therapist, and she's kind of ethereal, and I love her. And she's like, it's and she says, it's all about inflammation, right? It's just take turmeric and take resveratrol. It's a little bit more than that. It is a little bit more than that. So inflammation and autoimmunity, you have to kind of dig in and go, what's causing the inflammation? Where is it coming from? Yes, the inflammation is a big, big player. If you have inflammation in your brain, you're not going to feel good. You're going to have headaches. You can have a short fuse. You can have anxiety on a low level just from inflammatory processes. The issue is what's causing it. The thing is what's causing inflammation. So if you take turmeric, you take resveratrol, you take CBD oils, you take fish oils. These are some of the most effective natural alternatives to medical anti-inflammatories, and you have to take them at a proper dose. And for turmeric, you have to hope that the proper dose doesn't have you on the toilet all day with diarrhea. But you have to look beyond that, okay? Because as you're putting out the fire, all of these other things are still creating inflammatory responses that eventually your dosing of CBD oil or your dosing of turmeric may be covering up. You may be taking the CBD oil, which is now, from the last classes I took, is now ranked above turmeric, resveratrol, and essential fatty acids as far as bringing down inflammation naturally. And it does, okay? But you don't want to be doing that and ignore the fact that inflammation could be coming from you having a food sensitivity. Every time you eat a food that you're sensitive to, it creates an inflammatory response. Inflammatory cytokines are produced. They can flare up. They can create inflammation. They can attack your skin if it's Sjogren's. They can attack your salivary glands if it's lupus skin. If it's Hashimoto's, it'll attack your thyroid. And if it's MS, it'll attack your myelin sheaths, and on and on and on and on and on. So from the perspective of inflammation, even brain, even if you're looking at brain symptoms, if you're looking at seizures, if you're looking at any of the mood disorders, there is an inflammatory base to all of those. I have a colleague who teaches a brain, and he says, don't make it complicated. It's about inflammation, which I'm a little disappointed in listening to when I've attended those classes, because you want to go, no, it's about what does my diet look like? What am I, do, am I developing food sensitivities? What is my, do I have chronic infections from some sort of a chronic viral infection or something like that? Do I have small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, which is a chronic infection? All of these things, everything that you read about online, relative to what's triggering autoimmunity, every single one of these trigger this serotonin pathway, this inflammatory pathway first. When I have patients who want to know, what should I take for my, what should I take for my autoimmunity? I have like, a, like, I have like four or five things that I, four to five things that I tell them, look, when you're done and everything is like good and you're feeling good, there's like four things, that, four or five things that you want to take. To try to create a barrier so that you don't trigger your autoimmunity anymore. Well, the number one thing, is some sort of a natural anti-inflammatory, either like the CBD oil or the turmeric or the resveratrol or the omegas. Those happen to be my, the ones that I use because those are the ones that have been researched as either separately or in combination being the best natural anti-inflammatory. But I only recommend that after we have searched and found, well, is it chronic stress? Is it that you have a ton of food sensitivities? Is it that you got a leaky gut? Is it that toxins are getting out of your leaky gut? Is it that your gallbladder? All of these things should ultimately be tracked down to try to find out where is the source of inflammation coming from, as opposed to just because even though you're taking nutrients to dampen that inflammation, eventually, the fact that you're triggering inflammation all day long, you're either going to have to start taking more of that nutrient or eventually it's going to stop working. I hear it all the time. And I took it for a while and really worked, but then it stopped working. It didn't stop working. You just overwhelmed it because you never really took the effort or maybe didn't understand that you needed to look for what's causing the inflammation. And the question and the answer, well, life's inflammatory. Isn't enough. You got to find out what parts of life are inflammatory for you. And so that's kind of what I wanted to present on inflammation to give people a little bit better perspective on it when they're reading out there and somebody's got this inflammation. There's a radio program that I listen to and they have I won't say the name of the product because some of you might be using it going, it's great. But it's basically an inflammatory product. It's basically got turmeric in there and resveratrol and fish oils and one other thing. And they have, you know, a lot of people who've given positive reviews on it. And I, when I hear that, I just think, yeah, okay, so you've taken that and it's helped your pain. But what's creating the pain? And what other things is that doing or are those broken down functions doing other than creating the pain that's causing you to take this natural anti-inflammatory. So when you feel like, you know, you have inflammation, you want to look a little farther. You want to look and see, try to find out what's causing it and attack that as opposed to just, covering it up. Better covering up with turmeric and CBD oils and resveratrol than the anti-inflammatories. But nevertheless, that's kind of how I think relative to inflammation and autoimmunity and treating my patients relative to that particular aspect of their presentation.